Hi, I'm back with my map. To begin with, the answer to last episode's question is that the largest gathering of guitarists was at Poland in an event in 2009, where 6,346 guitarists played together, beating the previous record held by Meghalaya, India. Today, we'll be discussing an area which makes up more than 40% of India's landmarks. It is this inverted triangle inside the Indian Peninsula called the Deccan Plateau. A plateau is a flat area much above sea level. It does not have any peaks or valleys like a mountain range. There are various plateaus all around the world and some even underwater, like the Mascarene Plateau under the Indian Ocean. The Tibetan Plateau is the largest in the world and it is also called the roof of the world. But how are plateaus formed? The Deccan Plateau is about 2,000 to 3,000 feet above sea level, and it is bordered by the Vindhya and Satpura ranges on the north, the Western Ghats on the west, and the Eastern Ghats on the east. It was formed millions of years ago when the Indian tectonic plate was still on its way to joining the Eurasian tectonic plate. On its way, it encountered immense volcanic activity, especially around this area, which today comprises Mumbai. Over time, the lava spread out and hardened into layers of rock on the surface. This raised the Deccan Plateau above the other areas of land. So essentially, the Deccan Plateau is solidified lava, and that is why it is very different in form and texture than any other area in India. As the lava flows were not continuous, especially on the western side where the maximum activity took place, they formed steps or trepan beds, as they are called in Swedish. Therefore, they were given the names Deccan Traps. Since most of the volcanic activity took place in the west, it is believed that the intensity of the activity caused the entire peninsula to rise a little on that side. As a result, the Deccan Plateau is tilted towards the east, and most rivers therefore flow into the Bay of Bengal. Now the Western Ghats were formed along the western edge of the Deccan Plateau due to faulting and eroding over millions of years. The Western Ghats and their forests are so old that they were well in place even before the mighty Himalayas started to form. The Western Ghats are the first to receive the southwest monsoons and an immense amount of rainfall, as a result of which there is extensive greenery, wildlife, and some beautiful waterfalls all around. A journey on the Konkan railways at this time is especially memorable. And if you plan to make a trip on the Konkan railways after we start holidaying again, do be careful about the train timings, because the Konkan railways are the only ones to have a separate monsoon timetable. The Western Ghats or the Sahyadris start from around the Gujarat-Maharashtra border and they end 20 kilometers north of Kanyakumari, spanning a massive 1600 kilometers across six states. They are much longer than the Alps in Europe. On the contrary, the Eastern Ghats, which are even older than the Western Ghats, are discontinuous in nature, and on average their height is much lower. They start from Odisha and they go on to meet the Western Ghats in the Nilgiri Hills. Now, in the area around the Nilgiris, there is a flower, bluish in color, which blooms only once in 12 years. It holds a special significance for the area. Can you name it? I would love to hear your comments in the comment section below. Please don't forget to like our video and also our channel. I hope to see you soon in the next episode.